carbon likes to form four equal bonds. In the case of proteins, those bonds are with an amine group, a carboxylic acid group, a hydrogen, and another group. The other group depends upon the amino acid. Some of the other groups are alcohols, some of them are acids, some of them are bases, some of them are big hydrophobic groups, a couple of them are aromatic, i.e. related to benzene. They run the gamut of characteristics, but the hooked together side of the protein is always the same. It's an amine and a carboxylic acid. In the ribosome, the amino acids are hooked together through the carboxylic acid and the amine. So the nitrogen actually becomes part of the chain itself. Let's take a look at this, bond. The carbonyl oxygen, we've seen this in DNA, the carbonyl oxygen is a planar structure. This is all planar. The fourth bond in this carbon goes perpendicularly through it and pushes it out into a flat plane. The similar thing happens for the nitrogen. The nitrogen pushes the bonds out flat, and so this is a flat plane, but importantly is that the whole structure is a flat, it's all a flat structure. This is a plane right here. Recall in DNA that the hydrogen bonding for the nucleotide pairs, the hydrogen bonding is very much based on the geometry of the bases themselves. It's like the bases hold the hydrogen bonds together, and collectively they're very strong. The same thing happens with the protein. There's the peptide bond, it's like it consists of these rigid plates, and then the plates articulate against each other. And in the alpha helix, each hydrogen bond is formed between the hydrogen atom attached to the electronegative nitrogen atom of one peptide linkage and the oxygen of the carbonyl group of the fourth amino acid behind it. So that this forms a bond with this one for the fourth one behind it. As the peptides come off the ribosome, if it's the right amino acids, then the alpha helix spontaneously forms as being the lowest energy form. Some amino acids don't form alpha helixes, but I think perhaps most of them do. Many of them, or maybe most of them do. And if you look around in the structure of proteins, you see these alpha helices absolutely everywhere you look.